Everything you deploy inside of Azure will live inside of a resource group, which is a container that holds resources for a solution. It's up to you to decide how you want to organize your resources, but a popular option is to group them by lifecycle. You can group them by type, environment, or any way you'd like, but grouping them by lifecycle makes it easier to deploy them, update them, and delete them all at once. A resource group will also store the metadata of your resources, and when you specify the location of the resource group, that is also the location where the metadata will be stored. Keep this in mind for compliance reasons. Let's dive into the Azure portal and take a look at how we can create a resource group and also how we can delete a resource group. Alrighty, it is demo time. I am inside of my Azure portal and I'm gonna go ahead to the top and search for resource groups. I'm gonna go ahead and click on that. Next, you should have a list here of resource groups. If you have any, they'll be in here. Go ahead and click on create. And select the subscription you want to create your resource group in. Next, let's provide a name. It is common practice to end the name of a resource group with a dash RG. So I'm gonna call this demo dash RG. Next, you're gonna select the best region for you. I'm gonna go with East US 2. Then I'm gonna hit review plus create. Finally, create. Let's now visit that resource group that we created. We can see in the overview of Fuyu details like location and subscription. Below the overview is the list of resources that are in the actual resource group. Since this resource group is brand new, you're not going to see any resources, but let's change that. We're going to create a storage account inside of this resource group. We're going to hit create resources and we can search for storage account. And then we're gonna find it should be your top result. And then we're gonna hit create storage account. And just make sure the subscription and the resource group is set to the one that we just created. And then I'm gonna call this demo Gwen storage. One thing to keep in mind is that there are some restrictions to the name that a storage account can have. So if you hover over this information icon, it'll give you all those details. Everything else I'm going to leave as default and then go ahead and hit create. All right, deployment is in progress. This should take a moment. Fantastic. We're going to hit on the resource group inside of demo dash resource group. We should see this new storage account. It is still deploying. Hit refresh and there we go. Demo Gwyneth storage is finally there. Alrighty, quick demo, but it is now time for cleanup. Let's erase what we've created to avoid any unwanted charges on our account. And just make sure you are in the resource group and we have the option to delete the resource group. Next, for verification purposes, we have to provide the name. So it's demo-resource group and then hit delete. One thing to keep in mind is that certain resources require additional steps before being erased. So when you might go and try to delete an entire resource group, there might be something in there that's going to prevent the deletion. And until you actually go and take care of those additional steps, your resource group will not be able to be deleted. For example, there might be a lock policy on some resource and you'd have to remove that before being able to delete this group. So if we search for resource groups again. We should refresh now. Oh, it's still deleting. Let's give it a moment. But what we're going to take a look for now is just to make sure it's actually deleted. And there we have it. The delete of the resource group has completed. If we go in here, refresh, we can see that it is no longer in the list of resource groups. And that is it for this demo.
In this video, we discussed what a resource group is, why they are used in Azure, how we can view all of our resource groups, how we can create one, how we can create a resource inside of a resource group. And finally, to avoid any surprise charges, we deleted the demo resource group that we had created. Alrighty, Cloud Gurus, that's it for this episode of ACG Fundamentals. Go on and create some resource groups, delete some, and let us know in the comments how it went. Keep being awesome. I will see you in the next one.